This stinks. He tore the patellar tendon in his right knee last night. He's going to miss the rest of the season. You can see him just shaking his head there. He's saying, I'm done. I'm done. As soon as he landed on it. I mean.
That's the worst. That's got to be the worst, to get hurt on opening night.
Right?
Yeah. Be the absolute worst.
And to have it just to just know right away. It's no, like you could see with Hayward when everyone heard that sound and obviously saw it twist right away with him. He's like, I'm done. So first, we wish him a speedy recovery.
Speedy recovery.
It just, it stinks. Second, we would normally talk about the domino of how this affects the Nets, but the Nets don't even have their own pick this year, again. Who has that pick? The Cavaliers have that pick. And this gets interesting, not just because it could end up being a higher pick, but then what they do with it and how they use that in the LeBron James discussion now becomes different, possibly, if the Nets now...
I feel like that pick is insurance. If you're the Cavs, you have to look at it. This is my insurance policy if LeBron leaves.
Right.
And so you can say,
unless it's your chip to get him to stay.
But you don't
by
know
trading,
that.
By trading
you,
it.
You yourself,
for help
Rachel, you
this
say
year,
it, but Rachel, you say this all
know.
The time. You don't know what he's going to do.
You don't know.
You can't risk that unless the chip that you bring in is going to be here for a while.
You can't make that decision until he signs on the dotted line.
Yep.
Or he just leaves. So if he leaves, you get a top pick.
Yep.
If he comes back, maybe you use that pick and add another player to it to bring in somebody like Giannis.
Right.
Or you know, that'll be a dream scenario.
Good luck crying Giannis away from there.
But you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think it all, look, we do have to see how it plays out. I do always say that about LeBron, is that we don't know until that last week of the season. But you don't know also about other things. We've seen two guys get hurt. I mean, Jeremy Lin obviously is not going to change the balance of the NBA, but Gordon Hayward getting hurt could change things in the Eastern Conference. Mm-hmm. You don't know till you see the season play out how injuries are going to affect certain teams. If the Cavs see maybe an injury to the Warriors and they feel like this is it, if we win this year, we could go for it, and LeBron would definitely stay if they won.
Would
maybe
he?
They do. Yeah.
That's another question. Like
stays.
We say, he definitely.
I
don't know.
I think win or lose, he stays.
You think so? He stays?
I just don't see another scenario to where you could say, if I go here, we compete with the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah, that's true.
And we win. I do think that if they win, he stays. Again, my theory is the same. Last week of the season, depending on how they compete, will help make his decision. If Cleveland sees something go on in the West where they think we could actually win this, they might want to trade that pick to win it this year. We'll see. That pick now means something a little different with Jeremy Lin out. And again, Jeremy, we hope you feel better soon. Yeah.